it was important that people of color come together to say, we are going to make sure that we organize and mobilize so that we're not going to be waiting for government to ride in on a horse with a white hat and save us. Government will never save communities. Government will never provide the kinds of things we need to educate our communities. Money does not trump racism. I'm sorry to use that word. Middle-income African Americans are more likely to live in neighborhoods that's more polluted than whites. Black folks making $56,000 are more likely to live in neighborhoods that's more polluted than whites who make $10,000. You say, how can that be? Because of residential segregation and because of housing discrimination. It's easier, and studies show this, it's not just me up here talking and pontificating. It's easy for a white family to get into a neighborhood, a middle-income neighborhood that's white, and no pollution, no facilities, than it is for a middle-income African-American community. There's baggage that's brought with black people. And I'm saying that in reality. I'm not saying it in pejorative. The fact that if you are black and middle class, it's harder for you to get a house in a neighborhood that's considered environmentally sustainable and livable. The money won't get you there alone. You gotta overcome that hurdle called racism and discrimination.